Dear students, as part of the population policies and programs, we will talk about the module about population policy and indicators. This is an important aspect of population policies and programs, because the population policies and program monitoring completely depends on the kind of indicators that are used. In this module, we will talk about the report on world population policies from the United Nations, which gives lot of information about the policies and programs relating to population across the globe. Then we will talk about the kind of mechanism we have for monitoring the population policies and the progress made in this direction. Finally, we will talk about the definitions of various indicators relating to population policies in terms of various aspects and various components of population. Let us start with the report on world population policies. The latest issue of the World Population Policies 2013 is a report published by the United Nations. This report provides us details relating to government's views and policies relating to population and development. And this report provides the information for 197 countries. These include all the 193 member states of the UN, two observer states, and two non-member states. This is a very rich source of information provided by the UN on population policies on various aspects across the world. In detail, the report itemizes the policies in the areas of population size and growth, population age structure, fertility, reproductive health and family planning, health and mortality, spatial distribution and internal migration, and international migration. All these aspects are covered by the population policy report of the UN. Let us spend some time to understand about the monitoring of population policies. All the international population conferences of UN, starting from 1974 Bucharest conference, have laid greater emphasis to monitoring implementation of the goals and recommendations of the conferences. The latest data indicates that there has been considerable progress in monitoring the progress of the policies of the different nations by the UN. The ICPD conference, International Conference on Population and Development, that was held in Cairo in 1994, recommended that actions should be taken to measure, assess, monitor, and evaluate the progress made towards meeting the goals of the program of action. This is an important recommendation from the ICPD conference, because it emphasizes the need for monitoring of the progress made in terms of implementation of the recommendations by various countries. Systematic monitoring of population policies at international level commenced immediately after adopting the World Population Plan of Action at the World Population Conference held at Bucharest in 1974. The Bucharest conference gave the call to the nations that development is the best contraception. In continuation to that, the plan of action, which was the first global intergovernmental instrument relating to population policy. So, the plan of action called upon the UN to monitor national population trends and policies. So, let us move to the specific definitions of various indicators relating to population policy. To start with, There are some indicators relating to population size and population growth. Let us look into the indicator relating to population size. The indicator in case of population size is estimated mid-year population, and this is indicated in thousands according to the latest year. And of course, the revision of official UN population estimates and projections considers medium variant. The second indicator on the slide is about annual growth rate. Here we are talking about the average exponential rate of growth of population over a given period, and this is always indicated in terms of percent. Then we move to aging related indicators. We all know that population aging is an emerging area in many of the developing countries as well, whereas most of the developed countries have the challenges relating to population aging. So, let us understand the indicators that are used in case of population aging. One indicator relating to population aging is percentage of population under age 15 years. This is the estimated mid-year population below 15 years of age, and this is indicated as percentage of the total population. For instance, it can be 20% of the population of a particular country is below 15 years. This always, the denominator will be the total population, the numerator will be the number of people aged below 15. That is the way one has to understand about each of these indicators. There will be one numerator, there will be one denominator. Then another indicator related to population aging is percentage of population aged 60 or more. This again is the estimated mid-year population aged 60 years or over, and this is also indicated as a percentage of the total population. If you say that in India 8% of the population is aged or elderly, that means 8 out of 100 Indians are aged 60 years or more. The numerator will be the estimated mid-year population aged 60 years or more. Denominator will be the total population. Let us continue with the aging indicators. One indicator which is important from policy point of view is the statutory age at retirement. Here we are talking about the age at which a person is expected or required to cease work, and usually this is the age at which the people may be entitled to receive full pension or superannuation or other related benefits. It is always expressed in terms of years. For instance, if you say that in India the age of retirement, statutory age of age at retirement is 60, that means all persons above 60 who reach 60 rather cannot continue to work, and they are also entitled to get the benefits such as pension, superannuation, etc. Let us move to fertility related indicators. Let us talk about total fertility. When we talk about total fertility, we are talking about average number of children an hypothetical cohort of women would have at the end of their reproductive period if they were subjected during their whole lives to the fertility rates of a given period, and if they were not subject to mortality. It is always expressed as number of children per woman. If we say that the total fertility rate in a country is 2, that means a woman in that country on an average will have 2 children in her lifetime. Relating to fertility, we looked at the total fertility rate. Total fertility rates always talk about the general population, whole of the population. Whereas the adolescent fertility specifically talks about the adolescents. The indicator in this case is adolescent birth rate. This is the annual number of births to women aged 15 to 19 years divided by the number of women aged 15 to 19 years. That means the numerator is number of births given by women aged 15 to 19 years in a particular year. The denominator is total number of women aged 15 to 19 years. This is also expressed as births per 1000 adolescents or 1000 women who are in the age group of 15 to 19 years. Continuing on the adolescent fertility indicators, we have an indicator that gives the percentage of women aged 20 to 24 years married by age 18 years. So, here this is the percentage. You will have the number of women aged 20 to 24 years married by age 18 as the numerator. The denominator will be all the women aged 20 to 24. Here, the woman has to get married or entered a union before age 18 is the condition. When we talk about union, we are talking about involvement of a man and woman regularly cohabiting in a marriage-like relationship. Moving to the family planning or contraception related indicators. Here we are talking about the percentage of married women using contraception. Percentage of women aged 15 to 49 years who are married or in a union and they are using a contraceptive method or a family planning method. So, the numerator is number of women aged 15 to 49 years who are married or in a union and using a contraceptive method. Denominator will be all the women 15 to 49 years who are married or in a union, irrespective of the use of contraceptive method. Continuing on the family planning related or contraception related indicators, we also have two different methods or rather two different measures that are in use. One is the percentage of women using any method of contraception. It can be modern method or it can be traditional method. In family planning, we have modern methods like sterilization, condom, IUD, oral pills, oral contraceptives, injectables. These are all modern methods. We also have traditional methods like rhythm method, safe period, withdrawal, like that. So, the first indicator talks about the use of modern or traditional methods of contraception. The second one is the percentage of women using the modern method of contraception. So, the second one talks about only the modern methods. The first one talks about modern as well as traditional methods. To reiterate, the modern methods we are talking about include sterilization, oral contraceptive pills, IUD, injectable, implant, condom or vaginal barrier method. So, the difference between these two indicators is that the first one talks about any method of family planning, the second one talks about the modern methods only. The numerator is the number of women who are using the method, the denominator is total number of women of that particular age group. Let us continue the discussion on indicators related to family planning or contraception. Percentage of married women with unmet need for family planning. Unmet need is an important area in the area of family planning and contraception. Particularly in many developing countries, this is an important issue that needs policy and program intervention. From that point of view, this is an important indicator. Measurement of unmet need in an accurate way, in a scientific way, is imperative, so as to plan for program and policy interventions to enhance the contraception use in developing countries in particular. Here we are talking about the percentage of women aged 15 to 14 years who are married or in a union with an unmet need for family planning. And then how to define the unmet need for family planning? The definition is that women with an unmet need for family planning are those who are fecund and sexually active, but are not using any method of contraception, although they report not wanting any more children or wanting to delay the next pregnancy. That means the women are able to contribute towards childbearing, they are sexually active, but they are not using any method. At the same time, they do not want to have any child, or they want to delay the next pregnancy. They are supposed to be having unmet need. Another important indicator relating to family planning is index of family planning effort. This index measures the level of effort of national family planning programs. In 2009, this index was calculated for 81 developing countries. These include 93% of the developing world population. This family planning effort index is based on 31 measures related to family planning efforts, and they were organized into 4 components. The first one is policy and stage setting activities. The second one is service and service related activities. Third one is record keeping and evaluation. The fourth one relates to availability and accessibility of methods as well as supplies. So, each measure of the family planning effort was assigned a score ranging from 1 to 10, where 1 indicates non-existent efforts, non-existence of the efforts or very weak efforts, while 10 indicates extremely strong effort. And then this was developed on the basis of a survey questionnaire completed by 10 to 15 expert observers in each of the countries. The overall index for a country is total score for all the 31 measures, and this is expressed as percentage of maximum score that is possible. Then let us move to abortion related indicators. Here we are talking about induced abortion rate. When we say induced abortion rate, we are talking about number of legally induced abortions per 1000 women aged 15 to 44 years. The definition of induced abortion is that these are initiated by deliberate action taken with the intention of terminating the pregnancy. And then deliberate action with the intention of termination of pregnancy is considered as induced abortion. All other abortions are considered as spontaneous abortion. Then let us move to women empowerment related indicator. Here we are talking about percentage of women in non-agriculture wage employment, female workers in wage employment in non-agriculture sector, and this is expressed as a percentage of the total wage employment in the same sector. So, the non-agriculture sector primarily includes industry and services. Let us talk about mortality indicator. Life expectancy at birth is the mortality indicator. It is average number of years of life expected by a hypothetical cohort of individuals who would be subject during all their lives to mortality rates of a given period. If a child is born today, what is the life expectancy at birth for that child? That can be estimated. If it says that life expectancy at birth is 70, that means a child born today is expected to live up to 70 years. And then child mortality related indicators, we have infant mortality rate, which is the probability of dying between birth and exact age of 1 year. This is always expressed as deaths per 1000 live births. We have under 5 mortality rate, it is known as U5MR. Here it is the probability of dying between birth and exact age of 5 years. This is also expressed as deaths per 1000 live births. Then we have child health indicator, percentage of children 12 to 23 months with 3 doses of DPT vaccine. Of all the children aged 12 to 23 months, how many had received 3 doses of diphtheria, tetanus, toxoid and pertussis vaccine in a given year? Coming to child nutrition indicator, prevalence of stunting among children aged 0 to 59 months. The indicator is percentage of children aged 0 to 59 months whose height for age was less than 2 standard deviations below the median height for age of international reference population. As regards maternal health indicators, we have maternal mortality ratio, number of maternal deaths over a period of time, over a year rather, per 100,000 live births in that year. Then let us look into the definition of maternal death given by WHO. According to WHO, a maternal death is the death of a woman while pregnant or within 42 days of termination of pregnancy, irrespective of duration and site of pregnancy, from any cause related to or aggravated by pregnancy or its management, but of course not from accidental or incidental causes. In circumstances in which cause of death attribution is inadequate, maternal death can be defined as death of a woman while pregnant or within 42 days of termination of pregnancy, irrespective of cause of death. Let us move to maternal health related indicators. Here the indicator is percentage of births attended by trained health professional. We are talking about the percentage of deliveries attended by trained health personnel. Traditional birth attendants, we also call them as TBAs. Even if they had received a short training course, they are not included here. The definition indicates that the births have to be attended by trained health professionals. The numerator is that number of deliveries assisted by or attended by trained health personnel. Denominator will be total number of births. Let us understand the adult nutrition indicator. Percentage of OBC among adults aged 20 years or more. Here we are talking about the percentage of adults aged 20 or more whose body mass index BMI was 30 or higher. Body mass index is weight in kgs divided by height in meters square. This is the way to obtain body mass index, weight in kilograms, that is the numerator. Denominator is height in meters square. If you do this calculation, you will obtain the body mass index. And you compare the body mass index, and if the body mass index is 30 or more, then the person can be considered as obese. That indicates obesity among these population. Let us move quickly to the health indicators. The indicator is percentage of deaths caused by non-communicable diseases. The numerator is number of deaths due to non-communicable diseases. Denominator will be all the deaths due to all causes. It is indicated as a percentage. Here, the major non-communicable diseases we consider include cardiovascular diseases, cancers, chronic respiratory diseases, and diabetes. Let us continue the discussion on health indicators. HIV prevalence among adults aged 15 to 49 years is the indicator. It is indicated as percentage of adults aged 15 to 49 years living with HIV at the end of the reference year. The second indicator relating to HIV is number of people living with HIV. This is the estimated number of people of all ages living with HIV at the end of the reference year. Let us move to urbanization. One indicator is population density, population per square kilometer, that indicates the crowding or congestion of the urban areas or rural areas, whatever. But this is more relevant in the urban areas. So, this can be considered as an indicator relating to urbanization. The second indicator is about urban population. Estimated population living in urban areas at a mid-year, and this also can be expressed as percentage. And the definition of urban areas varies from country to country, depending on certain criteria used by the country or the territory. So, depending on the kind of definition given by the country for urban areas, the numerator will be population living in urban areas, denominator will be total population of the country. This can be done at state level, at district level as well. The numerator will be population living in urban areas, denominator will be the total population. Let us continue with the indicators pertaining to urbanization. Annual urban population growth rate. It is the average exponential rate of growth of urban population over a given period expressed as percentage. The second one is annual rural population growth rate. It is the average exponential rate of growth of rural population over a given period expressed as a percentage. The next indicator relating to urbanization is percentage of urban population in urban agglomerations. Here again, the urban agglomeration definitions vary from country to country. Depending on the definition used by the country for urban agglomeration, the numerator will be the people living in urban agglomerations, denominator will be the total population. Let us move to migration. Migration is one of the important components of population dynamics. Here we are talking about international migrant stock. It is the mid-year estimate of number of people living in a country or an area other than that in which they were born. This is always indicated in thousands. So, this is on the basis of place of birth. The second one talks about percentage of females among international migrants. Number of females as percentage of total international migrant stock in a given year. If the number of foreign born people is not available, the estimate in such cases refers to number of people living in a country or area other than that of their citizenship. The net migration rate talks about number of immigrants minus the number of emigrants over a period, divided by the person years lived by population of receiving country over that period. This is expressed as net number of migrants per 1000 population. Let us continue with migration indicators and talk about annual inflow of remittances. Remittance inflows consist of all current transfers in cash or in kind made or received by resident households to or from non-resident households. That way, The personal transfers include all current transfers between resident and non-resident individuals. Continuing with the migration indicator, the compensation of employees refers to income of border, seasonal or other short-term workers who are employed in an economy where they are not resident and of resident employed by non-resident entities. The data we are talking about are sum of two items, personal transfers and compensation of employees. This is in accordance with the definition given in 6th edition of IMF's balance of payment manual. And remittances are expressed as US dollars in millions. So, in this module, we have looked into the need for monitoring the population policies and the reports that are available from United Nations in this direction, and then looked at various indicators that are used in terms of fertility, in terms of mortality, in terms of health, in terms of maternal mortality, infant mortality, child mortality, maternal mortality, nutrition, migration, urbanization, marriage, etc. And then looked at the specific definitions of each of these indicators in terms of numerator, denominator, unit, etc. This understanding of the indicators and their definitions helps us immensely in monitoring the policy and program initiatives of various countries.